Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we entered into ConnectFX and started exploring the different ways of getting media with the accompanying alphas into the node-based compositor. The next step is to understand the flow of alpha through ConnectFX. In other words, you need to know how your alpha is going to be connected to make the best of it. I won't go through the functionality of every tool as we're more focused on the workflow, but all general principles with regards to alpha are the same in almost every node. So here we are back in ConnectFX. I am using single source clips and not matte containers to make this very clear, but it's your choice how to bring your alphas into ConnectFX. Now there are two approaches that you can use with alphas. For the first method, let's say for example, you would like to do a bit of work only on the alpha or matte before combining it with its corresponding RGB color channel on a background. In this case, you treat your alpha like any other source clip. So I will pull out a stylized node from the ConnectFX node bin and connect the output of the alpha channel source clip into the front input of the stylized node. Now I'll play around with the density, length, and thickness of the strokes just to ensure the matte looks completely different. This would happen to any image feeding into the stylized node. This is not specifically for alpha. So the result of the stylized node is going to be the final alpha which we'll composite with. To bring all the elements together in the composite, there are multiple techniques, but the easiest is called blend and comp. Some other systems might call this operation merge or over. This node has multiple inputs, but there are actually only three components to it. Red is the fill or front, blue is the alpha or matte, and green is the background. RGB is a great way to remember the color coding. RGB, front, back, matte, or alpha. So I'll feed the RGB channel clip into the front input. Now remember the color blue. You might sometimes feel this way, but in smoke, it is one of your favorite colors. Blue equals alpha. From the stylized node, I'll drag a connection to the matte input of blend and comp. See how the connection goes blue? Looking at the result, you can see how the alpha is being applied to its corresponding RGB channel over black. To complete the composite, I'll drag a connection from our background image node and connect that to the back input. So there is our composite. So to reiterate, the first approach of working with alpha is to treat it like any other clip until you get the result you want, and then use it to combine two other images together. If I used a matte container, the result would be the same, except visually, I'm intersecting the flow of the alpha to change it before combining it in the blend and comp node. But the result will be the same. The second approach is to simultaneously apply processes or filtering to the RGB color channel and the alpha channel. This is pretty much like an all-in-one process that you would have done in other applications. For example, I want to reposition my footage with its corresponding alpha to correctly position it within the frame. Let's scale it and move it to the side. To do this, I'll drag a 2D transform node from the ConnectFX node bin. Now looking at this node, it has a front and alpha input. So I'll break the original connection of the front and alpha and connect them both into the 2D transform node. This means whatever I do to the RGB fill will also be applied to the alpha, like a typical reposition filter. In the 2D transform controls, I'll move the layer to the position that I want. Hovering over the result view and pressing F4 will cycle the viewers between the result and the outmat view to show the effect on the alpha. To rebuild the composite again, I'll take the front result out of the 2D transform node and connect it to the front input of the blend and comp node. But this time for the alpha, I will drag out the blue matte result from the 2D transform node and connect it into the blue matte input of the blend and comp. That is how you would visualize the route your alpha takes to help build the composites. To reiterate the second approach, both RGB and alpha can be fed into a single node that takes both inputs. This results in the effects being applied to both RGB and alpha channels. Depending on the node's process, the alpha can be affected or used to hold back part of an image. For example, if you need to blur someone's face. Hopefully these methods will help you to learn the flow of the alpha channel between nodes in ConnectFX. As we conclude this part in the series, I would like to point out that every node in ConnectFX has a defined set of outputs. You can see the nodes that I have used all have a front and mat output. However, there is always one who is an exception to the rule. Action. In the next video, we'll go into action and look at how to configure it to output an alpha channel from the 3D composite. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.